What's going on, Weekendviibez family? It's your girl Lady G, and we're back with another video. In today's video, we're actually doing our very first DIY for this channel, so I'm super excited. I blinked out this bottle of Belaire phone on my friend's birthday, so make sure you stick around to the end of this video so you can see how I did it. Yeah. Skin deep rooted, your smile crazy and your ass stupid. I gotta ask, do you jump around a half an hour just to put your jeans on and you kinda laugh? We getting faded, the weekend vibe, I know it's your favorite. You and your makeup, flashback to the summer that we broke up. Put a hole in my heart like a donut. So guys, let's get right into this video. Here's the bottle of the Belaire. I don't know why I kept saying, calling it Belaire, but for some reason, that's what I thought the name of it was. Reading is very fundamental. Anyways, that's the bottle I got. I got this very cute little box on Amazon. It's actually a box that you could put wine in, but the bottle and the box is actually the same. I'll link it. It was from Amazon, so I thought it would be like perfect. So once the bottle was all bedazzled out, I would put it in here, and that's what I intended to use to present it to her. So as you can see, it has like a little opening pockets and the flaps where you see the white thing. Those are actually adhesive stickers where it actually forms into a perfect box for the wine, or in my case, for the champagne. So here's the box. Again, I'll have it linked on Amazon. Okay, I'm just over here fasting with this box. And then, I don't know why I'm just playing with it some more. Anywho, let's get into the supplies that I have. I have my hot glue gun. I got these paint brushes, Amazon again. So I have that link too. I picked up these little two makeup brushes that I never used, and I was like, oh, come in handy. I got a bow for the top, thought that would be cute. Now these rhinestones are actually the wrong size. I don't know if I'll end up using them or not, but we'll see. I have some tissue paper to lay down. I have this Mod Podge, and I have regular glue. I heard the Mod Podge is really good for stuff like that. Here's the glitter. I found these random glitters, so I don't know if I'll use them, but here they are anyways. So that's what I have for as far as supplies that I'm using. Very minimalistic. And I found these random studs around the house. Anyways, let's get right into it. Here I am. I'm just spreading everything out just to protect this table. And I'm starting off by actually doing the studs. So as you can see, they already have like a little adhesive to it, so it sticks. And I'm just adding some regular glue to it just to secure it some more. I'm using the end of that makeup brush, and I'm trying to align it because the label is actually not squared. So I'm trying to see how I can align it without with keeping it like in a box shape to go around the label, because I don't want to cover the label. So here I am just glowing and adding some more glue to the back of those studs that I found, and it's actually perfect because it matches really well. So just glowing in some more. And this is my actually first time bedazzling something like this. I've seen people like sell them on Instagram for some ridiculous prices. I mean, the prices that people are selling them for on Instagram, it costs more than what the actual bottle costs. And I understand time, effort, and labor. However, I feel like, okay, maybe you want to get like, you definitely want to make a profit. You want to make back the money you spend on supplies and maybe a little bit of the bottle. But the prices that people are charging online, when you can do this stuff yourself, it's very simple. I feel like everybody has a creative bug in them. Yeah, I just feel like the prices are very ridiculous. Anywho, here I am just going around some more studs around it and doing that. Yeah, let me let you guys enjoy the video a little bit. I'll come back and check on with you guys in just a moment. So these studs are actually coming along just great. Yeah, like I said, I'm just going around the label with the studs. I don't want to overdo it. And I'm just going around. And as I go, I'm taking my time and, you know, just trying to keep the glue and the studs off the label. And I'm trying to also make sure it's aligned.
Anyways, enjoy the rest of the video. I'll check back in with you guys in just a few. So I really like how the studs actually came out. Very cute, and it just matches so perfect with the label. Now for the fun part, I'm gonna get to use glitter. I'm super excited. I don't know why. I kind of have like a kid in me, like a mischievous one for sure. But yeah, just excited to play with this Mod Podge because, like, I don't know. I'm kind of gluing stuff together. I'm kind of mad that I actually did not use the hot glue in this video, which that's fine because I low-key only found one stick and I knew I had a few laying around. But anyways, so yeah. And I also had to make sure that I did not get any glue on the label. I'm really taking my time with this montage. Like, it was really hard to open. Yeah, finally got it open. That's what it looks like. Scraping that glue off the top because we're not wasting nothing. Yes, we are that type of person. I mean, when you guys open yogurt, right, do you lick the top of the yogurt label, or not the label but the cover of the yogurt? Do you lick that? Because I do. We're not wasting nothing. Anywho, I'm just applying the montage like ever so delicately around this bottle. Honestly, I saw a video on YouTube that inspired me to get majority of these products. I'm definitely gonna link her video. So check for that in the comment section. Not the comment section, but the description for this video. So I'm just laying it. She didn't really tell me how much to use, or maybe she didn't. I wasn't paying attention. Because honestly, when I watch DIY videos, I'm watching it for just like a general idea. I never do anything verbatim. But for my experience using the montage, I would definitely, if you use this and you're trying to bedazzle a bottle, I would go very light with the application, only because like drying time and then also the way that it looks, you want to make sure that it's like a smoothing, because the way the actual montage looks on the bottle is the same way that the glitter will look. So yeah, I would go around and do light strokes. As you can see, I'm not doing such light strokes. I would say the only time I really did less of the product was when I was going around the edges of the label, because I didn't want it to ruin the work that I just did trying to get the label together. So I'm just going around and gluing it. Is montage even glue? Can somebody in the comment section tell me if it's glue? Yes, I know what she's saying. Just go read the label. It will give you everything you need and more. Okay. But no, hit me up in the comments. Let me know if it's glue. And I'm just trying to keep it off the label too. That's like my goal. So everything will be covered. Even the description of the bottle. So yeah. Anyways, continue watching this video. I hope you're enjoying it so far. I'll be right back. So now it's time for the glitter, the moment that you all have been waiting for. You're tuning in now for glitter time. So yeah, like I said, just be very careful with this. As you can see, I'm being very dumb right now. I'm ripping off the label of the glue when clearly you can look at the top and see that's the part that's supposed to be open. But what let me struggle for a little bit trying to open this glitter? Oh, and yeah, you finally realize it's at the top. Good job. And here I am gonna destroy my plug-in for my hot gun glue just because I'm trying to struggle and open this glitter, when I'm pretty sure I should have just gotten a knife and gone around the little edge. Would have made it much easier for me. But no, destroy your hot glue gun plug-in. And also too, I destroyed the cap of this glue, not the glue but the glitter. To this day, I can't even get it to close. So I have to keep it in an area where I know it won't get knocked down. And I don't know, I need a container to put it in, because Like I said, what you're seeing now, I destroyed the cover of that. Anyways, enough about the cover. I'm just here applying the glitter. And one thing I realized from the girl's video that I did not see was, well, she didn't tell me how long it would take before I add another application of the montage. Yes, I am gonna go in. It's not just this one coat, although, you know, the one coat looks good. There's a few little spots right then and there that you can see around the bottom that was like left out. But montage, the way that it dries, the glitter actually doesn't fall off the bottle. I don't know if it's something different, but it's much different than regular glue. So I did one coat. I would say, if you do like coats, unlike me, I didn't realize that I had to let the montage dry a little bit. So you can see that I'm going in and some of the glitter started getting on the brush. I would say when you're doing this, I would give it a, like, at least 15 to 30 minutes to completely like dry. It doesn't take long to dry. And then you should go in with another coat. So I did not do that. And also, like I was telling you guys before, go light with the strokes of the montage. I'm just trying to cover out the pieces of glitter that I took off the top, because when I saw her video, she made it look like she put on a coat, glittered it, put on another coat. She probably stopped the video and her transition was so smooth, it looked like just one, and then she allowed it to dry. But yeah, give it about like 15 to 30 minutes to dry before you guys try to do another coat. So that's my coat. I let it sit for a little bit. My cousin was entertaining me on FaceTime. Me and her have this like ongoing joke. She calls me Gailey Minaj. That's like my alter ego, where like I do bad stuff. So I always joke to her like, oh, I go to Brooklyn at night and I bust car windows. Our inside joke. Anyways, that was a picture of what it looked like when I added the second coat of the Mod Podge. And here I am just going around cleaning up the label. This would be the third coat that I'm adding, so you can see what it looks like. And you can see that when I'm adding this third coat, because I did allow it to dry again for a little bit, this time a little bit longer since it was the third coat. And I'm lightly tapping it just to make sure all of the glitter was already dry and I'm not picking it back up. So I'm just adding my third coat of the montage so you guys can see what it looks like. And then I'm just going in a little bit now with some strokes, because I realized that it is dry enough and the glitter isn't going back onto the brush and it's not moving. So yeah, that's what it looks like. And I'm just applying, and I'm just taking my time going around making sure that I'm getting that label again. And like I said, give the montage a good 15 to 30 minutes to dry, and go light with the glue strokes. So yeah, I don't even know, I'm still calling it glue, because like I said, I don't know if it's glue or something else, but for now, until you guys hit me up in the comments, I'm calling it glue because that's what I think it is. So yeah, I'm just going in and that's it basically. So continue watching this video, you know, I'm giving you some fine tips. You're welcome. So enjoy the rest of this, guys. So this is the finished product. It's not exactly what I wanted, but I like it. It's my first DIY like this. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. Hit me up in the comment sections on more DIYs that I should do. Weekend Viibez, I know it's your favorite. You and your makeup. Flashback to the summer that we broke up.